Well, Stu, thanks for coming in today. You're obviously running for the auditor position. Tell me a little bit about what an auditor actually does.
County auditor's responsibilities involve elections, administering the elections in the county. They also do all of the claims for the county or pay the bills for the county, keep track of that. They do payroll for the county, all the county employees in the county. We also do some real estate, some of the transactions in real estate and keep track of some of that. Taxation, we certify the taxes to the treasurer. Trying to think of some other things. A board secretary, the auditor is the board secretary for all the board meetings. It's a very wide, varied, lot of different things that they do.
So you're gonna have quite a few things on the plate should you get elected. And this is your first time running.
Yes.
So
yeah, this is my first time.
Why run now?
Our county auditor has decided to retire, and it's just kind of a natural progression, I guess, for me to step up and do that.
Okay, and you've worked in the office with Kay Swanson, our current auditor, for 18 years. How's that been working with Kay, and do you feel like you're ready to step up and kind of fill her shoes, so to say?
Kay has worked in the office for many years, and so she has a lot of experience, and so that is always good to come into something like that with someone with a lot of experience, and you learn so much from that.
Right, and essentially the auditor position handles millions upon millions of dollars. What are your finance skills like, and are you ready to take on this kind of responsibility?
Well, actually, we just keep track of the money. We don't actually handle the money, but we keep track of it in reporting, et cetera, financial reporting for the state that has to go to the state, and those kinds of things. My background is I've worked for a seed company in the financial area, in the accounting area of a seed company. I worked for an attorney's office for a while, of course, took care of their books too with that. And my husband and I are a farm and have our business there, which I do a lot of the book work for that also. So I think it's a natural thing to step into.
Okay, very well. And earlier this week, Kay was absent from the county supervisors meeting, and you filled in. You're sitting up there with the supervisors. How did that feel? Potentially that's where you're going to be sitting as the future auditor. How did that feel, and how often do you work with the supervisors?
I have actually sat in on board meetings before when Kay has been gone, and So it's just a different experience just to have to get used to what you need while you're up there and what they're going to want and expect and keep track of course, what they're saying to keep the minutes. Working with the supervisors, I don't spend a lot of one-on-one time with them. Occasionally, I'll have a question that I need to go to them about, but they would work more directly with the auditor than with someone in the auditor's office.
Okay, so we heard a little bit about your experience. Tell us a little bit more about your education. What makes you a suitable candidate for an auditor position?
Well, I just have a high school degree. I did not actually attend a two-year or even a four-year degree. I've taken numerous adult education classes, and the experiences that I've had have been what I will use in the future.
Okay, so you win the election, you get into office. What are some of your goals, some of the things you want to accomplish as the future auditor or as the auditor?
I just think that we want to continue with things pretty much the way they are. There's always efficiencies that can be improved on and try to do everything as efficiently as we can, be as helpful and as courteous as we can in the office, and I would like to be involved somewhat with our auditor associations and be part of that and what happens in other counties too, just kind of get more involved with some of those kind of things. To have a friendly office and be able to keep all the records complete and accurate.
Great. So is there anything that you feel like you need to improve on, maybe brush up your skills in any areas to be a well-rounded, good auditor for the county?
I'll probably, yes. Everybody needs to do that. I think that probably my communication skills and somewhat, I haven't had to do things even like this interview. So those are kind of some of the things that I will need to do better. And there's a lot to learn. I know there is. I certainly don't know everything, and I will be anxious and excited for the challenge.
Well, I appreciate you coming in and doing the interview with me today. But is there anything else you want to add about running for this office position?
I don't think so. I think we've covered it. I'm excited for the challenge and to learn new and move forward.
Perfect. Well, thanks again for coming in.
Thank you.